First time in the ring announcer, Jimmy Lennon. Jimmy.
Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening to you, and we welcome you to the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino here in Hollywood, Florida, as we have a big night of action in store for you, and it's all brought to you courtesy of Warriors Boxing Promotions and Cedric Kushner Promotions in association with the Seminole Tribe of Florida and the Seminole Hard Rock Hotel and Casino, Hollywood, Florida, as sponsored by FriendsAnd.com. At this time, ladies and gentlemen, we present a championship attraction sanctioned by the WBC President Jose Suleiman, Supervisor Alberto Guerra, and the WBO President Francisco Valcarcel, Supervisor Luis Perez, along with the Florida State Boxing Commission. Judging at ringside for this bout, we have Bill Ray, Peter Trebatera, and Mike Ross, and our third man to the ring, the referee in charge, Brian Gary. All right, fans, here we go. 12 rounds of boxing for the WBC and WBO Latin American Junior Welterweight Championship. Introducing to you first on my left, fighting out of the red corner, is the challenger. Wearing red trunks with white trim, he is fighting out of Brooklyn, New York, by way of Ponce, Puerto Rico. His weight, 139 pounds. His record, 15 wins, 3 losses, with 6 wins coming by way of knockout. Please welcome the challenger, Andre Eason. And his opponent across the ring on my right is the defending champion, fighting out of the blue corner, wearing black trunks with white lettering, fighting out of Hollywood, Florida, by way of Monteria, Colombia. He weighed in at the super lightweight limit of 140 pounds even. He is undefeated in his campaign to the ring with 15 wins, no losses, 1 draw with 12 wins coming by way of knockout. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the WBC Latin American super lightweight champion, introducing Juan Iron Twins Urango. Once again, a referee in charge, Brian Gary, now to give instructions, 12 rounds of championship boxing scheduled.
All right, gentlemen, listen up. I'll be the third man in charge of this WBC, WBO Latino Championship at all time. You score a knockdown, go to the neutral corner. Do not come out till I signal. Avoid the use of your head as a weapon. No rabbit punches or low blows. Protect yourself at all times. Touch them up and come out fighting at the bell. Touch them up. Let's go. Peter, you good? Good. Ready here. You ready here. One. Under. Ready. Five.
So here we go, round one. And Eason tries to jump Arango right at the opening bout, unsuccessfully so. Eason has been inactive, and we said he last fought in November of last year. Did score an 8-round decision in that fight. Arango, on the other hand, has been quite active. Last fought in April when he stopped a pretty good fighter, Francisco Campos, in the fifth round.
Eason with nice work downstairs to the body. He's circling well. They both got to watch the front feet. See him there at the bottom of the screen? The front feet, when you're fighting a softball, you're constantly stepping on his foot and he's stepping on yours.
One thing to really keep an eye on with Arango is a tremendous body puncher. There he digs a left hand right to the ribs of Eason. He stopped Campos in his last fight with a body shot, one body shot.
That's a great weapon. You know, you also, you look around for the holes in the body. You're looking for the vulnerabilities and those pressure points. Hit a guy in the liver, hit a guy in the solar plexus, hit a guy in the short rib.
Meantime, Easton conducted himself pretty well here in this first round. He has scored on numerous occasions.
He scored and he's done a nice job of walking around. You know, you never want to retreat from your opponent if you can keep from it. You circle him. That gives you a better position to punch. Like that.
Pretty good right hand from Easton.
And a good combination comeback. Arango has some good skills downstairs to the body, and then he works his way to the head.
Uppercut and left hook behind that by Easton. Easton just got a sharpshooting here. Arango stalking him. Good body shot again with the left hand by Arango.
Arango building up those body shots. Those punches accumulate. You shake off head punches. Can't shake off the body shots. Look at this pressure from Arango, too.
I think Eason's doing a pretty nice job in this round, though.
Good skills, quick punches from Easton. Good first round, but he's got a long way to go.
Slips the right hand in. End of the first round. We're going to walk you back into the corner of Juan Arango. They call Juan Iron Twins. That's because he's got a twin brother.
Come on, son. Come
who
on.
Also is a
step
fighter.
The jab looking real good.
Yeah. A pair of Iron Twins also in his fist. Espinosa in his corner.
David Tura, of course, is with us here at ringside. David, we've been talking about body shots, and you can't emphasize the importance of a good body shot. Out of that set, I thought Easton did a pretty nice job. Round number two. Easton in the red trunks. Arango, the champion, in the black. Going 12 rounds here. The WBC WBO Junior Welterweight Latin Americas Championship. They get all that on one belt. You'd have to wrap around twice, right? You have to have a waist like David's to get that belt on.
Look at their waists. These two are thin. They are junior welterweights. They're over 140 pounds, and they are tough. Look at this nice work again this round from Easton. Easton doing a nice job of moving to his left. That's behind the southpaw fighter.
Easton trying to work the body a little bit.
No, they both have good skills. This is what championship boxing really is. They both have a direction. It is a stepping stone to a world championship. The WBC Latin America's title in WBO. But it's a place for these kids to start and to start their careers and to build and to learn. Look at these two.
Arango has really moved around in that learning process. He's from Colombia. But he moved to Spain because he didn't feel he was getting enough good fights in Colombia. Lives in Madrid now, but is working out of right here in Hollywood, Florida.
What a commute. Nice work downstairs to the body from Ethan. Arango is just like pressure. He's like water on a rock. Look at this. He's just in his opponent's face, making him work.
Slips a right hand in, digs a combination of the body.
I think Easton is learning how important that body attack is because he's doing a much better job here in the second.
There's a good left hand from Arango. Nice combination from Easton. Arango clearly the heavier hand of the two.
But you know what? Easton scores, then he gets out. Easton scores, he backs up, he moves over, and maneuvers. Really good skills.
Well, he's got an old hand in Yoel Ojuda in his corner. Pakzeb Judah's in his corner also.
Telling him to zab.
Ooh, very good.
Throw a few zabs. Giving him some instructions. I can see Judah over there. telling him, motioning to him, trying to teach him how to fight. You can use some of the power from Zab. Boy, good combination from Eason. And Arango on top of him smothers those combinations. Look at this pressure from Arango.
But he misses with two punches. And again, Eason gets three punches in. And another one slipped the right hand. Again, as we go into the corner of Andre Eason, but David, I think at the very least, this guy seems to me to at least come in here with an idea of what he wants to do.
Well, Eason seems to be doing a great job giving a lot of angles. Obviously, he's applying a lot of pressure. He's throwing combinations, putting a lot of punches together. And as far as Arango is going, man, the pressure is relentless. He's doing a great job coming forward.
The pressure is what is really, I think, affecting Eason. Look at this pressure and look at the movement from Eason. Eason's having to kind of turn away from Arango.
He's missing you big time. You know what I'm saying?
Get up. Look at Zab Judah.
Doing great. They
know
it's
not.
They
know it's not. They know it's not. He's so young. Like Zab. That's Joel Zab, the father of Zab. Great fighter, champion.
Yep. Round three.
Nice jab. Look at that. Good work. If he's in front of you and you can hit him, tap him with that jab and move around there. You know, by the third round, you get loosened up. Your muscles get warm. You start getting into the rhythm of the fight, and that's what's happening here.
There's a good left hand, sharp left hand. I think that hurt Eason. And Eason, the left hand of his own. But as we said, Arango clearly the stronger of the two.
Arango really putting the weight behind his punches. Moving in
with that left hand.
You can hear that.
Takes a right hand from Eason. There's another good left hand, and that backs Eason up. Eason has a tendency to drop that right hand a little bit, and Arango is really making him pay.
And really, Eason doesn't have enough power to keep Arango off of him. Arango is more or less walking through Eason, but look at the defense from Arango. Even though he's aggressive, he's using aggressive defensiveness. Hands up around his face and moving in, throwing punches. Arango putting his weight behind his shots. Again, they're asking Arango to double up. Eason, good combination. Both battling. Look how this is. Look at the ebb and flow of this fight. I know it's the third round, but it's back and forth. They're still trying to establish control.
This is Arango's best round so far. And still, Eason is getting some shots in. This is a straight right hand. Pays the price. You can see the strength of Arango right here.
Yeah, strength and a lot of upper body muscle. Look at his shoulders. And then compare those to Eason's shoulders. Eason uses a lot of movement, not as much weight in his shoulders. Arango.
I like the way Arango comes forward. You know, there's a little bit of the old Mike Tyson, and a little bit of Floyd Patterson.
Sure is, the way he holds his hands up.
Yeah,
real nicely.
And he's, there's a right hand, drops him. Just a straight right hand, and it dropped him in. Eason trying to make the case that it was a slip. I thought it was a pretty good shot.
It was a slip over a right cross. Good punch, Arango, and you had just called it, Arango more on the attack, putting pressure.
You gotta get inside, Greg. You gotta sit down on the shot.
Give an instruction.
Well, it's interesting, David, we were talking about the left hand of Arango, and all of a sudden he knocks him down with the right hand.
This is unbelievable. He's certainly establishing authority in regards to his power. And look at that. That's a man, that's devastating punches right there.
It's a right hook, and because Eason ran into it a bit. Eason's kind of going in face first there, trying to attack with his own right hand, and he gets tagged.
He's definitely coming on stronger and certainly establishing his power, slowing them down, getting through him, and certainly opening up that nice right hook.
Do you feel the tempo of this fight changing?
Most definitely. Either fighter is obviously applying a lot of pressure on Durango, getting the best of the both of them.
You know, Barry, they say professional boxing and championship fights, the fight starts after the third round. So here we are.
Well, let's see if Arango could stay on the gas. So far, very impressive, I think. I really like the way he has his hands, and I like his head movement.
Yeah, me too. You know, there's a lot of fighters who leave their hands down by their waist and they expose their chin. I like this. I like the. The philosophy is if you're stunned and you're hurt, you're not cognizant, you're not thinking right, so your hands are going to go where they normally go. You hold them up there, they're going to go there automatically. Yeah. They want him to stay on the body, they're telling Arango downstairs.
Still, it just looks to me like Eason has a tendency every now and then just to drop that right hand. He's really there for a counter.
You know, I do like this work from Eason. Eason now has changed his tactic. He is trying to go downstairs. Eason is the one doing that because he's trying to take some of that power out of the punches. Go downstairs for a few rounds and it'll make your shots just subside.
And catching Arango stepping in.
Oh, a lot of pressure. A lot of pressure. Right to the solar plexus.
Oh, another great shot to the body. And you see the arms of Eason drop. And he goes upstairs. Great job by Arango. And the left right hand, left hand, I beg your pardon, drops him again. I think the fight changed.
Yeah, it's a matter of time. He's been where he's going. Big for Eason right now. He's got to cover up, hold on, tie him up, do it again to keep him getting hit.
Well, that was a thing of beauty. He was working the body, got Eason's arms to drop, then he came upstairs and dropped him.
And you know something? Arango's going to be rushing after you. Load up with one of those right hands and let him run into it. For Eason, you've got to go down swinging. You know he's going to be all over you. He's going to be on you like a cheap suit. Throw.
Nice little combination from Eason. And weather the storm, at least for the moment.
Oh, he's tough.
Another good round, though, for Arango.
Rounds in the bank for Arango. David Tua, what do you think?
I tell you, Arango's walking right through Eason, and as far as he's concerned, you know, he's trying to slow him down, trying to turn him a little bit, throwing a few poppy punches, trying to slow his step down. But Arango, I tell you, he's coming on strong. He's coming on strong.
Do you see it being just a matter of time, or do you think that Eason can fight this off?
I believe Arango will eventually get to him. I believe it'll be a matter of time.
That was really caused with the body shots. That's what brought the arms of Eason down the first one.
It was set up in a body. The body attack is what caused the arms to come down, protecting the body and not realizing the chin is exposed.
David, you know, as a pressure fighter yourself, you got to love it when you see your guy starting to go backward.
Most definitely. Most definitely.
So here we go, round five. Two big rounds back to back for Arango. He has had Eason down twice.
The tide has really shifted. Arango showing his strength. He has set his fight plan since the opening bell. A lot of pressure. punches to the body and to the head. He goes downstairs to bring down the guard, and then upstairs.
And David's point is well taken. He's just walking through Easton now. Knows Easton can't hurt him.
That's where power is so important to any fighter, any weight division. Power to control your opponent. Only six KOs in his 15 wins for Andre Easton. Not a big power hitter.
Slip the right hand in there.
But he can sting you. When you don't have big power like that, you gotta have speed.
Nice work for speed. Oh, good left hand again. Back Easton off of it. Be a good idea for Easton to get out of here.
Yeah. The corner's not nice to him. Get out and then score. When you move your opponent, you got your angle on the opponent. Nail him. Circle around him and score. I like what he was doing earlier in this fight, too. Easton was moving to his left. It's an unnatural move for a right-handed fighter. But you take the power away from your opponent's left hand.
I really like the way Orlando moves forward. I mean, he's got very good head movement. You know, for a guy who's a pressure kind of fighter, he doesn't take nearly as many punches as you might expect he would.
He doesn't get caught with those big shots. The reason is he smothers the punches. When he moves in, they catch him on the gloves, on the hands. Look at his posture. It's so vital. That jab working. Get it out there, Andre. He's going to be coming after you. Get that jab working and then throw the right. Andre, too, dragging that left. See that left hand down by his waist? Not much protection for your chin there. Oh, those hurt. Those are good body punches. Those will hurt tomorrow and the next day. Strength from these two. Orlando trying to manhandle Easton. Easton fighting back.
Yeah, he's not like a nut game. He's just been out of muscle.
Time, gentlemen, time.
Going to take you into the corner now of Andre Easton. And, you know, I'm not sure what they can say to him. He's not fighting a terrible fight. He's just in there against a guy who's stronger, pressures him.
Well, he's trying over there. What do you think they're telling him, David, to him?
If anything else, if I was in this corner, I would certainly tell him to keep making angles and keep going to the body. Certainly trying to slow Durango's strength down with his power. I mean, as far as Durango's doing, he's doing a great job. He's applying a lot of pressure.
So we come to round six of a 12-round fight. This for the WBC, WBO, Latin America. Junior lightweight or super, or junior welterweight or super lightweight, take a pick.
Oh, body shot and into the head. Orlando, all over this.
I think there may still be a couple of rough edges on Orlando, but on the other side, he looks to me like the complete package. This guy could be the real deal.
Yeah, I really like what I see from him. I wish he weren't so stiff, though. It seems like he's struggling a bit in there. I think he'd be much more effective fighter if he could somehow loosen the tightness of him a little bit. It doesn't look like he's really letting go with his punches. Although it's evident that he is Andre Easton. Easton down in the third, the fourth, and just overwhelming the fifth. But my point is, he should be knocking people out with these heavy shots. That's a slip.
Then again with the right hook.
And what I like to see in these kids too is we've seen it here a little bit. Imposing your will on your opponent is extremely important and impressive to judges. You impose your will by doing things like making your opponent drop his guard, making your opponent stand in and slug with you like Eason is doing now. Making your opponent fight your game and you not fighting his game. There's a good uppercut. That's the best punch by Eason right there. The right uppercut, that's his best punch so far.
Came right back to it, but missed a little bit with it.
Should make the point that Eason has never been stopped in his career. His three losses all coming on the judges' scorecards.
And you can see why. He is tough. He's had plenty of opportunity to splash.
Watch your head.
Plenty of opportunity to exit. And he's tough.
Chopping right hand from Eason.
I like those uppercuts. Let's see if Eason can get back to those. Keep using. Look at that. There it is again. Keep it. If it's working, use it.
Better round for Eason. Gara starting. There's a double right hand from Eason. People are saying Gara starting to get on the gas a little bit, but I think Eason got to win this round.
6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Much better round, I thought, for Eason.
Yeah, Rango had a tough time that round. And David, too, I think Eason is picking up some of the things that Rango's doing.
I'll tell you, Eason, this is a great round for Eason because he's applying a lot of pressure and he's punishing Rango to the body. You know, he's definitely winning this round here. And you know, I tell you what, he's a tough kid. He's doing a great job in there.
The knockdown, you would have thought that Rango would have just taken complete control. Here is the knockdown back in third. And questioned the veracity of that shot, but he got up. And then in round four, he got knocked down again, but there's no quickness, kid.
To me, even though he's slowed right down, but he seems to be getting stronger as the round goes on. So he's doing a good job in regards to making him miss and making him pay to the body.
And each one of these rounds, he's getting more confident. Too, you think?
Most definitely not do so.
He's also taking more shots in his corner from little old Judah than he has, I think, from Rango. The uppercut slipped in again. This is still, at least on my card, this is still a winnable fight for Eason.
Yes, yes, and you know, you see the ebb and flow of this match. Still winnable. No quit in these two guys.
He's found a hole for that uppercut.
He has, and you know what? He hits him in an uppercut, a little bit of wobble there. Now, what happens in fights is you try a little uppercut, you see a little wobble in your opponent, and they tell you in the corner, he's wobbling, and you throw the uppercut. Use more of that. But he wobbles a little bit more the next time. There it is again. I tell you, he's found that is a great weapon. It is a great weapon against a fighter like a Rondo who leans over. See how Rondo leans over a bit?
He's fighting Rondo's fight in this round, and he's getting the better of it.
Look at that. No, to me, that's a thing of beauty.
There it is again, the uppercut.
Because this has been controlled. Somebody went out there and told him, look, you're landing with the uppercut. Keep using that uppercut. It'll work every time you hit him on the point of chin.
Why not? And your point again, very well taken. And Rondo's just leaning in. He's there for the uppercut.
Asking for it. Yes, he is. And nice job, too, by Eason by coming back with a hook after the uppercut. That has turned the tide in this fight.
Rondo is not nearly as busy in this round either.
Doesn't look as strong as he did earlier in this fight either. Very interesting. It is the sport of boxing. Boy, look at the muscles on Rondo's back. Holy moly. Look at that. Nice to see your back. There's a really nice strength. That's where his power comes from.
See, he's laying in there a lot. He's not punching.
Deontay, you see a different complexion in the fight here than you saw earlier back in that third and fourth round.
And left uppercut again. Oh. I think I've got his attention. And a good right hand. And that hurt Arango.
Oh, yeah.
Well, this is a fight, guys.
Oh, yeah.
Was in the midst of his best round.
What a turn of events. That is how exciting this championship boxing can be. There was a lot on the line in this fight. These are junior welterweights. They had the power of the heavier weights and the speed of the lightweights. Wow.
Yeah, the interesting thing about it, I mean, I had Eason winning that round easily. Yes. David, how did you see that?
It was unbelievable. I tell you what, he was making Arango pay every time he was leaning in with those uppercuts. I tell you what, there was a one particular time where I thought he had Arango hurt. But, you know, this is boxing. With a puncher like Arango, he can change the fight just like that.
And boy, did it.
One shot is all it takes.
Goodness.
You know, that right hook, too, from Arango is the one that the same punch that knocked down Eason earlier in this fight, in the third and fourth round. He landed it. He knew that was his weapon. The uppercut was dangerous for Eason. That was a great weapon for him, but that right hook, Arango remembered to use it, and he used it at the optimal time.
Yeah, there was one particular time where I thought Arango forgot to go to the body. But I tell you, with a puncher like Arango, you know, really, it was just a matter of time. Really, it was just a matter of time.
Strong. I mean, very strong.
Look at his back.
Yeah, look at his back, of course. No wonder. That, I'll tell you, star on the horizon.
Pretty impressive.
Juan Arango, he's very impressive. Nice looking young man. He's got the strength, he's got the power, he's got the speed, and he's still learning as a fighter.
It's still a work in progress. Still kind of leans in, and he's susceptible to things like the uppercut, but that's stuff he can work on in the gym.
Oh, yeah. Well, Eason did a nice job of trying. He came in here and gave a little heart, but crack, there is that right hook. What a terrific weapon. The hand down, look at that left hand of Eason down by his waist, and boom, right on the side of the jaw. Boy, you've seen a lot of guys bite the dust from those kind of shots, haven't you, David Tua? Your opponents.
I just got to use more often
look
of them.
That.
You got to get guys to drop their hands more.
Yeah, exactly.
Can you hold still right there for me, please? You know, you're a great heavyweight puncher. Do you pick up things from these lighter weight punchers like Arango?
You can never be a complete fighter as you would love to. I mean, in fights like this, you know, most definitely, I learn a lot from these fights. You take a little bit of this and a little bit of that from different fighters and make your own.
All right, let's get up to center of the ring. Here's Jimmy Lennon Jr. to make it official.
Ladies and gentlemen, we have the time of 2:59 in round number 7. He is the winner by way of knockout. Still the WBC champion, now the new WBO Latin American super lightweight champion, and still undefeated, Juan Iron Twins Arango.
A believer out of a lot of people here, David, is just what I thought he might be getting retired. He wasn't throwing as many punches. I guess that's the sport, isn't it?
When he took the time, Barry, I thought he was slowing down a little bit. But hey, this is boxing. With a puncher like him, you know, you can afford to maybe take a little bit of rest and then bang, and it was over.
He's a guy that's only had 16 fights now. And as you said, he still is kind of a work in progress. The boy's got all the tools, doesn't he?
What I love about Arango is the fact that, you know, during the later rounds, he was still able to keep his defense up at times. Though he was slowing down, but he was able to work off his jab. And that was really a matter of time before he could connect with that right hook. Look at that.
That was a good one. And that's taking advantage of an opponent's mistake. We talked earlier about the fact that Eason had a tendency every now and then to drop his left hand. And boy, did he pay the price there.
Well, at the same time, I have to give Ethan a lot of credit because he fought with a lot of heart. He did the best he could, and that was the way it goes.
Yeah, he did. As a matter of fact, I thought he came in here. We talked about this.